Hello, dear friends. I'm very happy to talk about my personal story, which can be entitled as Wu Dang Dao Zhang, Zhong Guo Meng, Wu Dang Taoist Master's Chinese Dream. Yeah, today, wearing such a clothes, such a robe, or such a hairstyle, people easily or respectfully address us, me or my kind, call us Dao Zhang, Taoist Masters. But honestly speaking, I'm not a born Taoist. I used to be working as a high school English teacher. So today when people find a Daozang, a Taoist master speaking fluent English and also playing guitar, they would exclaim, "Wow, a Taoist master can speak English. This is amazing. How this is, can happen?" You know, I'm not a born Taoist person, which was born in this deep mountain. And just like every other people, I also attend school, received my education. And after that, especially in China at that time, every parents wish the children would have a fixed job, which was called 铁饭碗, like a iron ball or metal ball, which is a very fixed job. So you will have no worry for life. You get a fixed salary from the government. So a fixed job, working as a high school English teacher. But now, practicing Tai Chi, doing something quite related to Taoism. In actual fact, yeah, completely, what I'm doing is promoting Taoist culture. So how it happens? Why I have such a transition from one job to another, from standing on the San Si Jiang Tai, three inches teaching platform, to such a career. This is a story about a Chinese person's dream. I was a English learner, so any English learner, they are familiar with the phrase American dream. I don't know whether there's a British dream or Indian dream. Anyway, when we learn English, we have some knowledge of the background knowledge related to all those English speaking countries, including the US. So the American dream, as you know, it says, everybody, if you have a dream to do something, and in that land, you can fulfill your dream. Of course, need some work, like a black child, immigrant from Africa. If you immigrated to the US, so something magic can happen to be an American president. Yes, it happened to Obama. Well, indeed, for at least a certain period of history, many people desirous to immigrate there. Of course, many other countries, especially in the times of, in the past few decades, Chinese people, quite many, they know about this. When I was teaching, I found many Chinese youngsters with the Chinese appearance. That's like late 1990s. I found them not so Chinese. The teenagers are very enthusiastic about what we say, what we think, like rubbish food. Ah, teacher, bring us to eat McDonald's. The other would argue, no, McDonald's, Kentucky. This party, no, McDonald's, no, Kentucky. So, both American food brand, take a look of their dressing, Nike, Adidas, of course, those from rich family. And a film, there's Hollywood. Sports, they talk about NBA. At that time, I was actually at the crucial moment of making a choice, life choice. What should I do? I also have the sense of brand, so I ask myself, what is our brand? Or I want to do something like, it can be global, something global. What's that? It's rather hard to do something very material, to make a restaurant, to invent something, to be worldwide influential. It was very hard. So I asked myself, what is that? At that time, I really was I was struggling very hard as what to choose. You know, I had been an English teacher for nearly 10 years and a good English teacher, you know, students liked me very much. I was very much recognized as a backbone English teacher. On the other hand, I'd had opportunities to come into the Wuda Mountain. You know, that's my part-time job to work as an English interpreter. While doing this job, part-time work, numerously, I was very, it's very impressive to about the nature, the culture, on the other hand, also impressive about how the foreign people, they feel about this mountain and also the culture. The most representative remark is such as, well, this is real China. I have dreamed to see. This really touches me, strike me a lot. So what to do, A or B? Still to hold this metal ball, means a fixed job, or to go into the mountain, to go onto the Wuda Mountain, based on Wuda Mountains, to promote this unique culture worldwide. Of course, this lit my fire.
Had you had any experience in Tai Chi or Taoism before making the decision?
My whole life, there's three different labels over around related to English. English teacher, an English interpreter, an English speaking martial artist. Three labels. But these three, not a very sharply, this period English teacher, this period English interpreter, this period English speaking martial artist. No, they're mixed together. So the first 10 years from 1988 to 1998, this is the period of my career as an English teacher. But the third year of this first work, 1990, I started to have a label as an English interpreter, because this is my second part-time job, working as an English interpreter. The fifth year of my work as an English teacher, you know, 1993, I started to learn Tai Chi Chuan. That's to say, when I did my first job, I already started my second job. When I did the second job, I already started my third kind of something great. Of course, finally, I get rid of one, I find something more interesting. Now, this is my lifelong pursuit. When I do my first job, working as a high school English teacher, actually, in 1986, I suffered from back problem because of violent sports exercise, playing table tennis. I was staying in hospital, so for 1 month. 1 month, I become recovered. So on the departure from the hospital, the doctor gave me advice, not suitable to the environment sports exercise. He suggested me to do Tai Chi. You are from Wudang, why not do Tai Chi rather than those violent sports? So this is very much motivation. So plus, working as an English interpreter to multicultural, if you can practice Tai Chi, that can work, helps a lot. Of course, at the very beginning, I don't know. Later, I can be among the martial artist or wellness instructor. I'm not really sure I can be among this team. But after so many years, you know, this is nearly 20 years since started from 1993. I have been in this circle more than 20 years. Today, I was Wudang. So this is Grandmaster Zhang Sanfeng, the founder of Tai Chi Chuan. I am a Sanfeng Pai lineage, 15th generation. It was in 2009, I was formally accepted as a Wudang Sanfeng Pai disciple. So how that happened? When I took foreign people, you know, in search of martial arts school, I had opportunity to have link with different schools, different Taoist masters, either you know, specializing in Taoist culture or martial arts or wellness. Indeed, that's something favorable about me because my English speaking talent, I can very freely contact different important person. Finally, of course, I had my comparison. Then from among the different masters, I found Master Zhong, who is my master, my Sifu nowadays. So I found him like both martial and intellectual, quite like a book written by a Westerner entitled as Scholarly Warrior. So he is my favorite among all. He also valued me very much. He trusted me to do the English version of his website. That's first ever English version related to Wudang martial arts. First ever, I should say. I'm proud to do that. So when I do the English translation, the Wudang masters, those people from Taoist circle or from martial circle, they all thought highly of my work. my master appraised me particularly, and me the same. But there is a question, you know, those foreign groups, they are not all from English-speaking countries, sometimes from Portugal, from Czech. Then it happens a Chinese master speak Chinese. Me, interpreter, I interpreter in it, from Chinese to English. Then the leader of that group translate my English to Czech or Portuguese. This kind of cultural activity is not efficient at all. Either the Chinese master could not wait, or the audience could not wait for the content. And the two people in the middle also feel very hard work. It's a big task. Before long, my master said, Gu, you have translated me many times enough, so you are familiar with my content. I suggest I don't need to talk, so you, right away, you immediately talk about my content. Maybe I just start a little bit, so you, on behalf of me, talk about this.
What was the brief story of your master? What was his background?
My master?
Yeah.
Today, talking about Wudang martial arts, Wudang Wushu, absolutely. If we name one or two big names, absolutely he is this one or one of these two. Even in the whole Chinese martial arts in this field, he's a big name. He's like a flag for Chinese martial Wudang martial arts.
So it's quite an honor that he asked you to...
Quite much. So I, of course, I'm proud to be in this team, Actually, or in the English language, both, I reach fairly high level and also combine the two, which is very rarely seen throughout the country. They are foreign people, they have traveled throughout the country. When they met with me, they have very, very big exclamation. Feel like pleasant surprise.
For your knowledge, how did you develop your knowledge? You know, are there any, well, you've talked about Lao Tzu's Tao Te Ching. Is that a formative book for you?
Talk about the knowledge. There are two kinds of knowledge if you want to promote the culture. One is the knowledge itself. One is the right way to pass the knowledge. You know, there, in our life, in China or in UK, there is a kind of a person. There is abundant knowledge in him, right? But he failed to teach, to spread, you know? I mean, the speaking ability, the promotion of this culture. 1993, 5 years after my graduation, I established a bookstore and first time practiced Tai Chi. You know, among all the high school teachers, I did that simply out of a kind of interest. Not really means, oh, I have a dream to be a Tai Chi master. Mm-hmm. Not that. But then another 3 years passed, 1996, I suffered from back, as I told previously. The doctor advised me later on, don't do something very violent. So that gave me another motivation to learn Tai Chi, plus to do a better job than all the other, than the common interpreter. So I think good to learn Tai Chi. Then in 1998, 10 years of my that first job, I, after so many years, hard struggle, inner struggle, whether to go on with this job, or to do something with the monk, tourism, with the cultural promotion, or with martial arts. Finally, I find more promising, much more great expectation to be related to Wudang. So I made a brave decision, big decision, to quit my fixed job, to be a freelance, to work on my own, to walk on the Dao, the way. That is a great way, as the way Dao. Daoism is a kind of philosophy. Philosophy means philosophy is something to make people wise. That's something, really something great. But at that time, I was not regarded to be on the right way. On the contrary, many people think I was crazy, something wrong with my way of thinking, I'm stupid. There are people
probably... Why do they think that?
Well, they think a fixed job. At the time, the whole town very rarely won having a fixed job and just give it up.
Mm.
The biggest objection, you know, that comes from my parents, of course, my parents, together with, they have formed alliance, I mean relatives, uncles, aunties, they sit together with me, sit in the middle, one after another, trying to persuade me to give it up.
And how did you deal with that? I mean, did the parents come around in the end?
That's a really hard time for me. On the hand, I must tell them, I totally understand you concern my parents, my, you know, upper generation. I just relate my reason, but they still, from adult experience, they point out the difficulty. So something possible, maybe something not good to my life. They seem to worry a lot, so, but they failed to get me back.
Mm.
Very determined.
Mm.
I started to go on this way until today.
So what was the journey from making the decision and overcoming the resistance from your parents to starting this?
That's 1998, because in 1994, Wudang San was inscribed on the World Cultural Heritage. My English, you know, was, my English was A1 in the whole this area. Many people think me even a little bit, they regret, like they feel pity. I can do something higher than simply being a high school English teacher. Eventually, I also think the same way. I think I should do something related to tourism, related to culture. And since Wudang Mountain is World Cultural Heritage, I analyze this great title about Wudang. So Wudang should be world level. This place should be something international atmosphere. I mean, if foreign people come here, they cannot understand the Chinese language is something so alien to them. So in order to match this title, World Cultural Heritage, so me, who has a good command of English, I should do something. I can find my play, full talent of mine. So that's what I think. Another aspect, the World Cultural Heritage, I think it should be more cultural, but at that time, I think the whole town more commercial rather than cultural. So I think myself, like an intellectual person, I have very much sense about culture. So I want to do something related to that. The beginning, not really come onto the mountain. In 1999, I established a Wudang, like a cultural exchange center downtown, offering training program like English music, offering English service for foreign people. Not really dare to come into the mountain. So I run a center, like a training center, occasionally do the English interpreting work and practice Tai Chi as a hobby. So then in 2004, I had opportunity to obtain a house in a mountain. So that started me the journey to run an institution to teach Kung Fu and Tai Chi. But at that time, I still, even if my level was good enough to teach, I just think I am the founder of the school. I can arrange, there are many people practitioners. Why should I always stay on a training ground? So I first time formally established a Wudang. It's named Wudang Taoist Kung Fu School.
Mm.
So in, of course, you know, the journey indeed is rough.
Mm.
It's rough, just as my parents or relatives, they once expected, they once worried about. But I'm perseverant enough to overcome difficulties.
Mm.
My Chinese dream. So I think there must be something doing this, no matter how difficult it is. If I give up doing this, the other people don't have interest doing this. And the culture is so unique, so brilliant, so beneficial for mankind. So should we just let it hidden? Just the ancient architecture tells people about a brilliant history, brilliant past. There's no live in person doing something related to this culture. So I ask myself, so I still go on, wind my way,
mm.
you know, forward.
Mm.
So the hardships, including many times having to change place, changing sport, you know. One time you change your place,
mm.
that means cost,
mm.
expense to some degree.
So you said like originally you didn't want to stay necessarily on the mountain, that you'd have teachers, and clearly you're here today for 5 days a week. So do you, has something changed inside of you that you want to be here?
Well, if I did something very good downtown, now and then had opportunity to bring foreign people offering the service up in the mountain, I think that is quite good.
Mm.
So hardly I had thought, idea to do something up in the mountain.
Mm.
But then in 2004, here's an opportunity. A young couple from New Caledonia, overseas province of France, you know, east of Australia. That's like island countries, a very, very small country for me. They had a few days tourist on it. Before their departure, they mentioned the tea plantation. They want to visit a tea plantation. So up in the mountain, there is a tea plantation, very famous. At that time, I didn't know about this area. So it is on the other mountain ridge, named Ba Xian Guan Cha Chang, 80 Moto Temple Tea Plantation. I bring them there. So that's a good talk. But I'm not sure whether later on they had the tea, like tea trade, these kind of things. But what happened is the head of the tea tea plantation, the village. They showed interest in me. They think me an amazing guy who can speak English to foreign people. They say, do you like want to have a place up in the mountain? So they showed me a place amid the tea plantation. That is a village primary school. That's a four-story building with a courtyard. That place first ever start my, I look at the landscape and I think that's great. Since in long run, since at that time I already had the English version website, I mean to promote this culture worldwide. Okay, I must have a place up in the mountain rather than in the town. Also that in that year, something also happened to my family. So I think it's just good to have a place up in the mountain. So that's the first year, 2004. In 2009, I shifted to this area and formally to use the name Wudang Taoist Wellness Academy, focusing more on the wellness to help people for their longevity and good health. That's my story of Chinese dream.
Amazing. So I've got a few questions. So first of all, how has Taoism affected your thinking and your life?
As I showed you yesterday, you know, the water, I make use of this water to show you something. So no matter what happened, so the water remains even. 心平气和, when we do the meditative standing or sitting, we say these four words. Nothing else in the world can be so even as water. So to maintain good health, remain calm state of mind is of vital importance. Down the thought, after all, is to help people, you know, to raise the quality of their life. To obtain both quantity and quality, to live long and live well. To live well, to live healthily, the mentality is priority. No matter how well eat, no matter what exercise you do, if you don't have a good way of thinking, everything is in vain. So in chapter 8 of Tao Te Ching, it says, 上善若水, 虽善利万物而不争, 出众人之所悟, 故几于道. My Taoist name, my master gave me the Taoist name, Gu Shi Ning. Ning means peace, tranquil. Yeah, peace, tranquil. Thanks to such a name. Of course, the Taoist philosophy itself helps me to be thinking that way, to do things that way. It's not me alone. Actually, Taoist practitioners, all Taoist, typical Taoist practitioners, they are trying to obtain inner peace. They also know the importance to maintain peaceful with people, harmony among themselves, among them and others, among humanity and the world. I should say, Taoists are the very group, you know, to advocate peace. So we advocate peace. That's why Dewey, the famous educator from the US, he once pointed out, in future, in the whole world, in a world of very common world, it means if such a world arises without so much difference of nationalities, different, you know, so much separation, if each one of the people in the world should hold a book, you know, for the guidance in common, this book is Dao De Jing, written by Laozi from ancient China. That's what was said by a Westerner. So your question, how it influenced my life. I know the balance of yin and yang. So the world, everything indeed is complicated, but the Taoists think it's not that complicated. It's simply yin and yang. The formula of happiness, or the solution, or the key to resolve things is the balance, yin and yang, find a good balance.
And two more questions. So if you were talking to a 19-year-old, what advice would you have based on your own experience in your life that could help them? So 19-year-old, some advice that could help them in their life.
You mean those people born from 1990s to 2000?
Well, 19, okay. Someone who's just going into university, mm-hmm. someone who's growing up and needs to find his way in life, or her.
To learn from water. Water is very soft, but water is very powerful. So to find a good balance, the water is both soft and powerful. No matter give 10 thousands of a punch to the water, water remain calm. Finally, it is you feel exhausted, not water.
Okay, and final question. Is there a story behind the hair? You know, is there any reason it's done like that?
You see, in the ancient time, when the barber didn't come into being as a trade, barber, you know, to cut in the hair. So ancient people in China, I think in foreign countries as well, people normally wear long hairs. Nowadays, Taoist people in China, Taoist people are one of the very few people in the whole country that best preserved something from the ancient. The way of dressing and the way of hair dressing. It is probably because the Taoist people or Taoist, those meditators or cultivators staying up in the mountain normally are quite separated from the town's life. While the town's life, already they have the barber's trade, they started cutting the hair. This is my analyze. So this is my bold analyze. Those people staying up in the mountain still remain long hair. Once there's a young boy, you know, catching sight of my long hair and murmured to his mother, "Mom, why this uncle, you know me, a male person, why he wears such a long hair?" The mother explained in an amusing way, which is quite true. In Asia, it's true. Because the uncle, you know, hardly have time to cut hairs.
Mm-hmm.
In ancient time, you know, when there's not a regular road link the mountain and the town, so the people, once they come into the mountain, scarce they go out. So eventually the hair will became long.
Mm.
And also the image of one of the Chinese ancients, Fu Xi, he wears long hair. And the Wudang god, the number of Wudang god, Zeng Wu, he wears long hair. So, and the theoretically speaking, the Taoist people, they say, Bai Shan Xiao Wei Xian, among all the virtues, be pious to parents, that comes the first. And they think everything, your skin, the hair, everything are born from your parents' body. So just remain it rather than cutting it shows your devotion to parents. That's the inner culture and analyze.
Mm.
And people generally have impression that Tao, the Tai Chi Chuan practice, you know, looks very fluid. With the hair, they think that also add beauty to glamour to Tai Chi rather than bold hair. Mm. You know, this is a big contrast to external type of Kung Fu, especially from a Shaolin era.
Mm.
It's bold hair, while the Taoist people or Taoist practitioners with this long hair and this robe, this is a typical image.
Mm.